हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी प्रिंसिपल ऑफ शू ब्रेक। नाउ ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन द शू ब्रेक इज एक्सटर्नल रेडियल ब्रेक। इट इज एक्सटर्नल रेडियल ब्रेक दैट ऑलरेडी सीन इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर, राइट। नाउ एक्सटर्नल रेडियल ब्रेक मीन्स on a brake drum, let us say this is a brake drum. On this brake drum is rotating, let us say it is rotating with angular velocity omega. On this brake drum we are applying pressure or force externally. This is how we are applying force or pressure externally for braking purpose, right? Let us say, therefore consider there is a, for this shoe brake there is a brake drum, let us say this is a brake drum. Now on this brake drum we are going to apply external pressure. On this brake drum we are going to apply external pressure. Let us say this brake drum is rotating in anti-clockwise direction with omega velocity, angular velocity omega 1, right? And this is a brake drum. Now on this brake drum our target is to apply external force for braking purpose, and let us say there is a friction material in contact with this brake drum. Right, this is a friction material. Here it is a friction material which is connected in front of steel shoe. This is a steel shoe, and we are applying force on this steel shoe. This is a applied force on steel shoe. Now for this purpose, now we have to see the direction of friction. We have to see the direction of friction and braking torque, and we have to calculate braking torque. Let us say the coefficient of friction between this brake drum and friction material is mu. Mu is coefficient of friction between brake drum and this friction material. Now if I see free body diagram for this brake drum, let us say this is a brake drum which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. This is rotating in anti-clockwise direction with omega 1, angular velocity omega 1. Now due to the application of force or friction, it is rotating with another angular velocity omega 2, means its speed is decreasing because of the braking action. Now the force is applied like this, force F is applied on the brake drum like this, and as at the point of friction, this point is moving in upward direction like this. This is a direction of motion for this point because it is moving in anti-clockwise direction. No, means the point of contact is moving in upward direction. Therefore, here frictional force will be in downward direction. This will be the direction of frictional force, which is nothing but mu F. This also we have seen in first lecture of brakes and clutches topic, right? This is a friction force. How to find direction of friction force and how to find magnitude of friction force, that already we have seen, right? Mu F is friction force opposite to the motion. And if I see the shoe, steel shoe and friction material, let us say this is a shoe. On this shoe there is a friction material. Now the shoe and the brake drum are in contact with each other, therefore there will be action reaction pair. For this EF there is equal and opposite EF on the shoe. This is a shoe, right? As per Newton's third law, there is, for action there is equal and opposite reaction, as well as for this frictional force mu F there will be equal and opposite reaction on shoe, that is mu F in upward direction. This is how we have to put action reaction pair, that is as per Newton's third law, for action there is equal and opposite reaction on the other component, right? Now here can I say the braking torque here is braking torque. We have to find this braking torque TB, which is nothing but TB is equal to, now see, if the radius of drum is considered r, and on a drum the friction is in downward direction, that is mu F, friction force mu F is in downward direction, and from at radius r, therefore what will be the braking torque will be, it is mu F, that is frictional force into radius, and this torque is responsible to decrease the speed. Now see, can you imagine here, this braking torque is acting in clockwise direction. this braking torque, can you say, acting in clockwise direction and disc is rotating in anti-clockwise direction? Anti-clockwise direction means because of this braking torque, the speed is decreasing. That is mu f r is a braking torque. Right. Now, our target is to find total energy, which is nothing but heat generated. Now, our target is to find total energy, which is nothing but heat generated. Now, what is total energy or heat generated? Or heat generated, can I say here the total energy or energy, total energy or also called energy, total energy or also called energy is equal to braking torque into angle of rotation theta. This also we have seen in previous lecture. Now, which is nothing but heat generated, which is nothing but heat generated. This is the principle of braking. This is the principle of braking. Means whenever brake is applied, then the total energy in the component is converted into heat energy, and this heat energy is dissipated to the surrounding. Therefore, can I say energy is equal to heat generated is equal to braking torque TB into theta. Right. This also we have seen in previous lecture. Now here, what are the dynamic equations? Dynamic equations for linear motion, final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus AT. V is equal to u plus at. Similarly, for angular motion, the final angular velocity omega 2 is equal to initial angular velocity plus alpha t. This is the equation of motion. This is the equation of motion. Right. Therefore, from this, can I say alpha is equal to omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by t. Right. That is change in angular velocity with respect to time. That is alpha is change in angular velocity d dt of omega with respect to time. This is how we can write alpha. Right. Again, linear displacement, yes, is equal to ut plus 1/2 at square. This is for linear velocities. S is linear displacement, u is initial velocity, t is time, a is linear acceleration, t is time. Similarly, angular displacement theta is equal to omega 1t plus 1/2 alpha t square, where theta is angular displacement theta. Omega 1 is initial angular velocity, t is time, alpha is angular acceleration. Therefore, can I say angular displacement alpha is equal to omega 1t plus 1/2 alpha. Can I write instead of alpha omega 2 minus omega 1 change in angular velocity with respect to time into time square? Now, therefore, simplify. Therefore, theta is equal to omega 1t plus 1/2. Now, here 1t will get cancelled. Omega 2 minus omega 1 into t. Now multiply separately. Therefore, this theta is equal to omega 1 t plus omega 2 t divided by 2 minus omega 1 t divided by 2. Now make the common denominator. Make the common denominator. Therefore, omega 1 t divided by 2 into 2. There will be a common denominator. Now, as there is a common denominator, simplify. Therefore, theta is equal to 2 omega 1 t. Theta is equal to, can I write here, theta is equal to 2 omega 1 t plus omega 2 t minus omega 1 t divided by 2. Therefore, theta is equal to, can I write omega 1 plus omega 2 divided by 2 into t, which is nothing but theta is equal to omega t. Omega t, where omega is nothing but omega 1 plus omega 2 divided by 2, which is nothing but average angular velocity. Average angular velocity. Right, average angular velocity. This is how we can write. Or simply, instead of all these calculations, we know that the angular velocity, we have derived the formula of angular velocity from the principle of dynamics, that is from engineering, with the concept of engineering mechanics, angular velocity concepts. Now, can I say angular velocity is equal to angular displacement divided by time? Therefore, from this also we can write angular displacement is equal to angular velocity into time, where omega is average angular velocity. Average angular velocity, because here angular velocity is continuously changing from omega 1 to omega 2. Hence, as omega is angular velocity changing, we have to consider average angular velocity, which is nothing but omega is equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 divided by 2. That is final angular velocity plus initial angular velocity divided by 2. Put the values and braking torque. Braking torque is friction force into radius. Put the values. Therefore, total energy, which is nothing but heat generated, is equal to TB into theta, which is nothing but mu F into R, right? Into theta is omega T. Omega T. राइट। देयरफॉर हीट जनरेटेड इज इक्वल टू, कैन आई से हीट जनरेटेड व्हिच इज नथिंग बट इन जूल, दिस इज एनर्जी और नॉट, एनर्जी इज इन जूल राइट। हीट जनरेटेड इज इक्वल टू, कैन आई राइट म्यू एफ इंटू आर ओमेगा इंटू टी। नाउ फॉर नाउ लीनियर वेलोसिटी इज इक्वल टू आर ओमेगा, दैट इज रेडियस टाइम्स एंगुलर वेलोसिटी। दिस इज ऑल्सो इक्वेशन फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स, v इज इक्वल टू आर ओमेगा पुट हियर। देयरफॉर हीट जनरेटेड इज इक्वल टू म्यू एफ इंटू वी टी, दिस इज इन जूल। नाउ इफ आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड पर टाइम, दैट इज हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम, हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम इज नथिंग बट डिवाइड विथ टाइम। देयरफॉर म्यू एफ वी विच इज नथिंग बट जूल पर सेकंड, इट इज जूल पर सेकंड हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम राइट। अगेन इफ आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड पर यूनिट एरिया, लेट अस से आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड हीट जनरेटेड पर सेकंड पर यूनिट एरिया, दैट इज हीट जनरेटेड पर सेकंड पर यूनिट एरिया, द यूनिट इज जूल पर सेकंड पर एमएम स्क्वायर। इफ आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड देन आई हैव टू डिवाइड विद एरिया, देयरफॉर म्यू एफ वी डिवाइड बाय एरिया। नाउ हियर फोर कैन आई राइट प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू, प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू फोर्स डिवाइड बाय एरिया, पी इज इक्वल टू फोर्स डिवाइड बाय एरिया पुट हियर। देयरफॉर म्यू पी वी, म्यू पी वी विच इज नथिंग बट जूल हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया, हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया विच इज कॉल्ड थर्मल कैपेसिटी, विच इज कॉल्ड, दिस इज कॉल्ड थर्मल कैपेसिटी, थर्मल कैपेसिटी। एंड ऑन दिस थर्मल कैपेसिटी द वियर ऑफ एनी फ्रिक्शन मटेरियल डिपेंड्स, ऑन दिस थर्मल कैपेसिटी द वियर ऑफ एनी फ्रिक्शन मटेरियल डिपेंड्स। देयरफॉर कैन आई राइट हियर हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया इज इक्वल टू म्यू पी वी इज कॉल्ड थर्मल कैपेसिटी, थर्मल कैपेसिटी। एंड दिस थर्मल कैपेसिटी डिपेंड्स ऑन, दैट इज थर्मल कैपेसिटी हीट जनरेटेड पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू प्रेशर एंड वेलोसिटी प्रोडक्ट। एंड ऑन दिस हीट थर्मल कैपेसिटी द वियर रेट डिपेंड्स, देयरफॉर वी कैन से वियर रेट ऑफ मटेरियल इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू प्रेशर इनटू वेलोसिटी राइट। बट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वियर रेट कंसेप्ट इज नॉट दैट मच इंपॉर्टेंट इन ब्रेक्स, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन क्लच डिजाइन। नाउ द इंपॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट इज दैट डिजाइन ऑफ शू ब्रेक एंड बैंड ब्रेक। सो इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट डिजाइन ऑफ सिंपल शू ब्रेक। थैंक यू डियर स्टूडेंट्स, in next lecture we will start design of simple shoe brake.